Well, please welcome onto the bridge, along with myself and John Lear, Dr. Joseph Resnick, who works with John on the Pegasus Project. Dr. Resnick, you've been a guest on the program before, yes?
Yes. Hey, good evening. Hey, John, how are you?
Hey, John, what's going on?
You don't even know. You don't want to know. Hey, you know, I missed you at a seminar out in Las Vegas a couple of years ago. You were 10 or 12 minutes ahead of me, and I wanted to shake your hand and say thank you to you. You know, you have me posted up under Dark Secrets on the on your page.
Yeah.
Good to talk to you finally in person.
Great to talk to you.
So do you fellas work together or what?
Well, sort of, yes of, no of, in a roundabout way.
Well, tell the audience what you do in case they don't know who you are.
Well, John has written some things and posted some information about me, about moon mining.
Ah.
So.
What about moon mining?
Wait a minute. John, I sent you an email a few minutes ago. John Lear, at your email.
Okay, let me check.
Yeah. Well, that photo up there, those bubbles, guess what that is?
Which bubbles where?
Up on Coast to Coast email, or Coast to Coast site tonight, you have those pictures of moon anomaly?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, guess what that is? That's a wellhead.
The one at Aristarchus?
Yeah, that's a wellhead.
A wellhead.
Yes, we're getting up there, John. H3.
Oh, yeah, the...
H3.
Helium 3, oh. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to give you... Okay, it's 4:40 a.m. Eastern Time. Okay, 10 minutes, no holds barred. I have an agreement in stone that I can talk about stuff. Okay, I'll give you 10 minutes. Ask me anything. Ask me anything that you want to know about the moon mining, H3, who's involved. Okay, you got... It's 4:41 a.m. Okay, go. Now.
Okay, you have the rights to 90% of the moon minerals?
Well, here's how that happened, John. When I was a young man, I was involved with developing the speech technologies and next generation stuff for the military. It came to my attention that they brought this, you know, they brought this stuff, the moon mining stuff.
Yeah.
Well, it was new back then. It was new. Well, I'm going back 30 years now, John. I'm going back 30 years when I was a kid. So, you know, I'm the little guy sitting in the corner. I've got all these egghead PhDs, you know, talking about this stuff. And I said, well, what if we do this? Shut up, kid. I said, well, what if we do? Shut up. Well, guess what? The kid didn't shut up. The kid went forward. I said, well, how about if we do it this way? So I went and did it that way. You know, so, you know, those guys have walked off the planet since then.
Okay, so who is the wellhead on Aristarchus? That's to mine helium 3.
See those bubbles?
I could look for them. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's on Coast to Coast. Okay, if you go on Coast to Coast AM right now, and you pull that up, and
yeah, it's about the third picture from the top, and there's several of them at the upper left. Yeah, those are what?
Yeah, look at these bubbles.
What are those bubbles?
Yeah, guess who the guy is that does bubbles? Me.
That's cool.
Yeah. What does that mean?
Be cool. Extremely.
Listen, you guys, hold on a minute. You guys may understand each other, but there are several million people out there that may not. So what are you talking about?
Oh, the bubbles. You mean the perfect spheres that I have labeled as perfect spheres?
Yes.
Yeah, guess that's the first quote-unquote perfect spheres. Nothing's perfect. But
okay.
The first spheres that we made in space were aboard STS-41 and STS-43.
Okay.
We made spheres. We made microspheres. And those microspheres are still today the only and first standard to calibrate, guess what, Hubble, You want to calibrate Hubble? Come to me. I give you the spheres to calibrate Hubble.
Okay, now you know that there's two Hubbles, right?
They're more than two.
That's great.
31 board.
Well, every time I think I got a story, somebody's got a better story.
I told you, okay, well, the clock down is now 43.
Yeah.
So I give you 10 minutes.
Okay, were you the one in the lab that had the reptilian working with you?
As a matter of fact, he had nictitating eye lenses, and he was down in Florida. Yeah, I am he.
Yeah, that's the story. And his and the way you could tell was that he'd close his inner eyelid every once in a while.
Well, he had glasses on, and then he pulled his glasses on, and he pulled his glasses off. I said to him, John, I said, hey, why are you wearing his glasses? He said, well, where I'm from, it's pretty bright. I said, what do you mean? He said, well, it's pretty bright where I'm at. So they had three suns where he comes from.
Yeah.
Pleiades, undoubtedly, John.
Yeah.
Undoubtedly. They had three suns there. So this guy was, he was absolutely looked like a human being. Full bird colonel, by the way. Full bird.
Yeah.
Full bird colonel. I said, what the hell's the matter with your eyes? Pardon me. So, well, it's pretty bright where I come from. The next day I show up there, down in Florida, on the West Coast there. They told me, Dr. Resnick, you don't have access. Your access is denied now. I said, well, I have a meeting with, Colonel so-and-so. So access denied. I said, well, where is he? Not here. So, hey, John.
Okay, just want to confirm that story. That's good. Go ahead.
Well, I appreciate, you're keeping in touch with me and following me through the years and stuff. What do you want to know about moon mining?
I want to know if we're doing it.
Hi, Mikey, it's me again. Duh.
Are we mining helium-3 on the moon? If so, how do we get it back and forth?
I have been trying for the last 7 years to put together the team to do that. And there's...
But we haven't done it yet.
Well, I'm not going to say that. Even though I give you unrestricted, and it's 4:46, I've got 4 minutes left, 5 minutes. Now here, there is a young man who lives in Liechtenstein, and he is very, very wealthy and funds all of these projects. He funds these projects. Young guy. Just go into a store in any of the portals that you go into and buy some, Cobell candies or Swiss chocolates. The kid owns everything. He owns everything. Young kid. Young guy. Well, he's in his 30s now. First time I met him, he was 17. He's in his 30s now. But they fund everything from Liechtenstein.
Okay, and so why is he important to us?
I'm sorry?
Why is he
said, why is he important to us?
They fund everything.
Oh, okay, I see. Now, have you been to the
they
moon
the
yourself?
Money. It's the money.
Yeah, the money. Have you been
John,
to the moon yourself?
Follow the trail. John should know this, as he was cut out of his inheritance. Just follow the money.
Yeah.
See who's putting up the money.
Okay, now, have you, Joe, have you been to the moon yourself?
I just love my iMac.
John, I have not. I direct everything from a little place out here in the woods, and I have people that work for me, and I do things, and I travel, and still do stuff for PEO. And
okay, now, do you know somebody who has been to the moon?
I do.
Okay, and I'm not talking about the Apollo astronauts, but somebody else.
I do.
Okay, good. Well, I don't know what to do with my...
I can't tell you his name, but I can tell you that I have sponsored that individual to be part of the first Mars mission, and and he has been approved. He's a good guy.
Okay.
He's a really good kid. I have been with him and mentored him for the last 20 years or so.
Yeah.
Many are picked, few are chosen. He's a good guy. Good kid.
Okay, Joe. It's
a one-way trip up there, don't you, John?
No. What's the
deal? One way.
That's what I heard, but...
it is. It's one way. We can get you there, but we can't get you off because of the atmosphere. The atmosphere is absolutely volatile up there. Despite what NASA, you know...
We can get somebody there, but we can't bring them back, huh?
It's one way, John.
Can't we get the guys there to help us?
Pardon me?
Can't we get the people who live there on the moon to help us?
The entities on the moon are not people.
Okay.
They're not people. They're not like us.
Okay. What areas of the moon do you know most about? Where all this stuff goes on? The landing, for instance.
Oh, we have multiple sites.
Okay, tell me one.
There's a place on the backside of the moon.
What's the name of it?
It's about 70. Well, it doesn't have a name yet.
No.
We haven't given it a name. It's about 70 miles high. That's the takeoff and landing port.
Huh.
It's seven on the backside of the moon. If you look at the front side of the moon, you see all these deviations.
I'm very familiar with both sides. Just tell me about where it is on the far side.
John, I can't tell you that, but I can tell you. If you've been watching, postings lately. Well, it's 4:50. I got 2 minutes.
Hold on.
Some kid took a picture that was posted on the internet.
Hold on.
This little girl took a picture real close to those coordinates. Real close to those coordinates.
Okay.
Close. It was, she couldn't get back behind the 32nd degree. She could only go to, you know what, we're working with Google Space right now on our Orli project and MI projects to bring this technology forward.
Yeah.
It's a really good, it's good technology. John, you should call me, connect with me. I'll give you this stuff.
Okay. Let's get together.
All right. That's Dr. Joseph Resnick.
I have to get off. It's 4:51. I have to get off. John, I've been watching you for many years. I'm a friend of yours, supporter of yours, and I think you simply rock. And I appreciate Coast to Coast and George Norrie and Art Bell, and it was a pleasure to have spoken with all of you folks and to all the listeners out there.
Wow.
You know, there's a lot of stuff going on out there that people should know about.
Oh, wow.
And they pay guys like me that they keep, you know, down in a dungeon and throw me a bone every once in a while.
Yeah.
Don't let me drop it.
So I come out of the woodwork. This happens to be one of the nights I'm out of the woodwork.
Well, thank you for the information, Joe, and send me an email.
I shall, John.
Okay.
All right. Okay, it's 4:52. I got to go. Okay.
All right, over and out. Thanks for joining us. That was Dr. Joseph Resnick. Hey, John Lear. So tell us.
He is one of three guys that owns the major portion of, or has claimed, the mining rights, mineral rights to the moon. And what he did with this group is went to the United Nations. And, of course, countries are not allowed to claim any part of the moon. But these individuals... being not countries, were allowed. And if you go to thelivingmoon.com, you'll see all the paperwork that we have there on the claims that these guys made for the minerals on the moon. Apparently, what the interesting part was that he used to work with reptilian in his laboratory. And he told us that the eyes were very strange. He wore dark glasses, and that when he took the glasses off, he could tell he was a reptilian because of the inner eyelid that would open and close every once in a while.